Hello, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here today to talk about managing ML workflows in production with Amazon SageMaker. My name is Vinicius Caridá. I'm from Brazil. I'm an AWS machine learning hero, and also I am a head of data and AI and digital customer service at Itaú Unibanco in Brazil. So before we start to talk about ML, I would like to reinforce that all the applications, all the ML applications, in the end of the day, we'd like to try to make a good impact in the customers, in the users, in the company. So when you look for this picture here, that is the data science map, all the applications in the end of the day impact the customer. So you need to build applications, manage all these applications, and to do it is very hard, it's very complicated. It's because that Anthony Penta say that the hardest part of the ML is not the ML, but the massive amount of effort put into maintaining ML system. So it's easy to become dependent and difficult to support. In other words, launching is easy, but operating is hard. Why it's hard? It's because the ML code, it's complicated, it's important, but it's only a small piece of this entire environment that you need to build to have the wonderful applications and applications that really put value for the users, for the customers, for the companies. So when you look at this picture here, you can see that ML code is a part of this ecosystem. And you need to have a very powerful infrastructure, very powerful tools to allow us to bring this, to build this cycle, ML life cycle that start in understand the use case that you need to solve, then acquisition and exploring the data, select the algorithm, build the data pipeline and future engineers, build the ML models and evaluate these models. Once the result was good, you need to present the results for the stakeholders, plan, do the plan for deployment, operationalize the model, and of course, monitor the model in production, and sometimes retraining and start again all this life cycle. It's because this complexity inside this all this ecosystem, you can see in multiple studies that more than 87% of data science projects never make it to the production. This is a lot of projects that not go into the production because the complexity that have to build all this environment. But the good news, the Amazon, the AWS can help us to build an end-to-end data strategy. Here in the last reInvent, the swim present us the entire ecosystem, the entire platform with a lot of projects, products and services that help us to build this end-to-end data strategy. And if we can go through the machine learning part, we'll have a broadest and most complete set of machine learning capabilities. And here you can think about machine learning in three different layers. So the lower level layers, you have the frameworks and infrastructure that help us to build and put the model in production. And the high level layer, you have the AI services. So services that you can use very quickly and bring machine learning for our own applications. But today, our focus is the middle level layer, because here in the middle, we have the ML services. So here we have a lot of services that allow us to build the entire life cycle in one integrated tool. It's Amazon SageMaker. So Amazon SageMaker help us or help organizations to harness ML in different perspectives. In ML engineers' perspectives, helping to deploy and manage their models at scale if Amazon SageMaker ML Ops. In data scientists' perspective, preparing data, building, training, deploy ML models with SageMaker Studio. and business analysts' perspective. Make ML predictions using an interface, a visual interface with Amazon SageMaker Canvas. So in the end, this one and integrate tool, Amazon SageMaker, help us to build this environment in terms of infrastructure, tools, visual interfaces, workflow, orchestration, and collaboration in teams. So going a little bit deeper in some services that help us to build workflows, you can use Amazon SageMaker pipelines. With Amazon SageMaker pipelines, you can create ML workflows with an easy-to-use Python SDK, and then visualize it and manage your workflow using Amazon SageMaker Studio. So you can be more efficient and scale fast by storing and, of course, reusing the workflow steps you create in SageMaker's pipeline. You can also get started quickly with built-in templates to build, test, register, and deploy models, so you can start with a continuous integration and continuous deployment in your ML environment very easy and quickly. So once you have your workflows, you need to track in your models. It's very important part to put the model in production. So Amazon SageMaker pipelines logs every step of your workflow, creating an audit trail of your models, components such as training data, platforms configurations, model parameters, and learning gradients. So audit trails can be used to recreate models and help to support compliance requirements. And more, addition it, you need sometimes reproduce your models in production to troubleshoot models' behavior and determine the root case. So once the Amazon SageMaker logs every step of your workflow, so you can use linear tracking and you can recreate your models to debug potential issues and, of course, improve your models. So very important thing here. And of course, once you have this tracking, this workflow, automatic workflow in production, you need to have a centralized view to manage the versions of the model that you're training after. So many companies have a hundred of workflows, so each with a different versions of the same model. Then you need and can in this tool here track models versions, their metadata, and you can group the for use case and to see the model performance metrics baselines in a central repository where it's easy to choose the right model to deployment based, of course, in your business requirements. So in addition, SageMaker Model Hedges automatically logs approval workflows for audit and compliance. So you can use SageMaker Studio to browse and discover models, and or you can access them through the SageMaker Python SDK. You can choose. So once you have all this data, all these metrics, and etc., and you can choose the right model, the next step is to put the model in production. So you need to serve this model. You need to serve the inference of this model. And of course, SageMaker once more can help you in this different difficult task, because for different needs, you need different strategies. For example, you can have real-time synchronous response, near real-time synchronous response, or offline batch inference. So for each one, this strategy, inference on SageMaker can help us to strike the right balance and complexity. For example, because the model size, the payload size, inference workloads, but the performance and cost. You need to achieve the right balance of these three complexity things, and inference SageMaker can help us to put this model in production. And of course, ML development workflow should integrate with the deployment workflow to rapidly deliver new models for production applications. So in this entire application, Amazon SageMaker products bring CI/CD practice to ML, such as maintain partly between the development and production environments, source and version control, A/B testing, and end-to-end automation. As a result, you put a model to production as soon it is approved to increase agility. So, in addition, Amazon SageMaker offers built-in safeguards, so to help you maintain endpoints available and minimize deployment risk. And SageMaker takes care of setting up and orchestration, deployment best practices, and such a blue-green deployment to maximize the availability for your system, your solution, and of course, availability for the customer and the users in the end. And as you see in the ML lifecycle, once the model in the production, you need to have the opportunity to continually retraining the model to maintain the product, the prediction quality of this model in production. So SageMaker model monitor constantly monitor models performance and each a lot of characteristics like accuracy or other measures that you need to put in the production. So we can monitoring the model and of course integrate with a SageMaker clarifier to improve visibility into a potential bias. So we can monitor and put the better models once again every time that you need. So to shift to the theory to practical, I would like to share with you three very good sources to start to use it in the practice, hands-on things here. So the first one is this tutorial, Automate Machine Learning Workflows. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create and automate end-to-end machine learning workflows using Amazon SageMaker pipelines, Amazon SageMaker model registry, and Amazon SageMaker clarifier. And then when you do this first tutorial, you can go deeper and do this second one with is build MLOps workflow in Amazon SageMaker projects, GitLab and GitLab pipelines, an entire application here using a SageMaker templates. And the last one, you can build automating, managing, and scale ML workflows with using ML, using Amazon SageMaker pipelines is another very, very good post that you can use to learn more and put in practice all these concepts. So thank you very much again, and I hope you can use all these tools to bring value for your customer, for your applications. Again, this is my email and my LinkedIn link. I'm here to help you. Thank you very much.